I just got to shoot basketball and shit, right? My little homie right here just beat me out of bankroll, right? I don't even think he even know how to count that far. Look at him, man.
How you feeling? How you feeling?
Hey, man, he finna ready to go back to school. He going back to school with a bankroll, man. Tell the folk, man, paper route behind this, man.
Paper route, number 100.
Get paid, young nigga.
I'm finna roll, bro.
Wednesday, November 17th, 2021. Adolph Robert Thornton Jr. was shot and killed in Memphis at Makita's Butter Cookies. Maurice Hill, the owner of the shop where the shooting happened, told Fox 13 his employee said young Dolph, then 36, walked into the store to buy some cookies. Someone then drove up and shot and killed him at the South Memphis Bakery. Not only to Memphis, but to hip hop and the entire culture, this was a tragic and very, very devastating loss. Young Dolph's death in Memphis led to chaos and a war, with suspects being killed and others fleeing the city to avoid getting caught. And police have identified multiple suspects, some charged with murder and others wanted for questioning, with Govan considered the mastermind. His acts of charity galvanized his reputation in Memphis, a city dealing with poverty, gun violence, and disproportionately high incarceration rates of black people. In 2020, Young Dolph donated $25,000 to Hamilton High School alone for new sports equipment, his alma mater. Though Young Dolph may be gone in physical form, he is survived by his soon-to-be wife, Mia J, his two beautiful children, Trey Trey Thornton and Aria Ella Thornton, whom some say are almost identical, spitting images of the man himself. Beyond his timeless music and his philanthropy, Dolph was known for something else, being a family man, a father, a stand-up guy. This is just a peek, a slight glimpse into the man he was, you know, outside of the studio, off the stage, you know, outside of the interviews. The humble father, Adolph Thornton Jr., AKA Young Dolph.
I'm gonna tell you how it go with kids. If you let kids make all the decisions, like, it's just, you doing it wrong. You gotta help them make their decisions. You gotta mold them into what they wanna be in the future when they 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 years old.
I just want my son to grow up and realize who he is, know exactly what he is, and don't look for no confirmation from nobody. You know what I'm saying? I want him to know what he been through, not just him personally, but his ancestors, like how hard we fought, like how hard his granddaddy went, how hard his daddy went to get us in position to change the generational curse, the generational well-being of our family. You know what I'm saying? I just want him to be a thinker and be a worker. Like, that's all I ask. Because if he a thinker and a worker, he understand responsibilities. So if he understand responsibilities, hey, he can take everything I got and keep it going.
Yep.
Trey Boogie, what you doing?
Nothing.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
I thought you was going to let them hear the music. You letting them hear the music?
Uh-huh.
But what you doing?
Letting them hear it.
Hold on. Your granddaddy calling.
Granddad.
Dad.
What's up, Junior?
What's up, Dad? What you doing?
Oh, man. I'm not here with these women, though.
Hold on. Your boy want to talk to you.
What's up?
Junior.
Tell him what's up.
What's up?
Ask him how you doing.
How you doing?
How you doing, man? I miss you, man.
I miss you too.
There.
I'm
finna hit you right back, Pop. Trey Trey letting them hear some new music right now.
We're gonna hit you when we get out. I just call and say hello.
Okay.
Alright. I'll talk to you later.
Alright, there.
Alright.
Yeah.
Well, What about these four? These four are yours and these four are mine.
What?
These four are yours. Wait a minute. Next.
Okay. Drop new music. Say, we finna drop.
Daddy gonna drop new music.
I told y'all I was bullshit. Now, how about that, motherfucker?
I think you need to hear something else, Trey.
Clean version?
We ain't got no clean. Your mommy ain't in here. We listen to the clean version when you were mommy. You listen to the regular version when you were daddy. Okay?
Looked at him, said, nigga, get paid.
Yeah, try buggy.
Yeah, I hate fame, but everybody know my name. Hate come with money and they both come with the game. Everybody love me, now this shit seems strange.
Yeah.
All them diamond chain, he look like a rich slave.
Yeah. $250,000 around my neck, hot boxing in a Lamborghini truck. Yeah. Bust down the rich and milk for blue diamonds in it, I don't give a fuck. Yeah. 200 bags in one neighborhood and four houses, that's us. Yeah. I had a chick before they even knew who I was. Yeah. She my bitch, so she got a lot of bags and drive a G63. Damn. Smoked a blunt, made a mistake, went on an 80K shopping spree. Damn. Fur coats in the wintertime, you know it's drop tops in the spring. Bitch, pretty girl, whatever you wanna call her, but she with the shit. Yeah. Entrepreneur, the rich, niggas dope, boys are tight, yup, she love this. Yeah. Talk shit, swallow spit, she grab the dick, then do a magic trick. Ooh. Every nigga trapper, whatever you wanna call the boy, but he the real one though. Yeah. He came from the bottom, up under the bottom, but nowadays the boy living though. Yeah. Rolls Royce is on top of Rolls Royce. Bad bitch, screenshot my Porsche. Ain't that many real niggas left, it's a shortage. Rich nigga hotboxing in a Lambo. Boy, nice, pulled up on in a camo. Y'all back filled up to the top. That pussy so good, I woke up the next morning and bought her a watch. $250,000 around my neck, hot boxing in a Lamborghini truck. Yeah, bust down the rich and milk for blue diamonds in it, I don't give a fuck. Yeah, 200 bags in one neighborhood and four houses, that's us. Yeah, I had a chick before they even knew who I was. Yeah, she my bitch, so she got a lot of bags and drive a G63. Damn, smoked a blunt, made a mistake, went on an 80K shopping spree. Damn, fur coats in the wintertime, you know it's drop tops in the spring.
Like, daddy, you want to play? Let me hear some new music. Play your songs. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
He like listen to songs that he never heard before. So, my son, he, I don't know if it's nosy or he just be curious. You know what I'm saying? Like, right. he let me hear something. Like, I went on my little brother house, my nephew house the other day. We was over there, chef in there cooking food. I go in a little side room where they got the studio with my son in there with the headphones on, making a song. Mm-hmm. I like, man, y'all don't take them damn earphones off my son, man. You know what I'm saying? But
so you don't want mommy to comb your hair, you want daddy to comb your hair.
Yeah.
Woo, go, Ari, go, 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 go. Good job, bro.
I want to go to 10.
That is 10.
That was 10.
Five. It's 10.
That was not 10. On the count of 10.
2, 3, hey, hey.
It is just like your dad.
Hari tells everyone how amazing her dad was and how much he loved his chocolate baby.
Daddy, I love you. Make sure you have a great birthday. Love your chocolate baby.
Trey is coming into that special young man you always spoke that he'd become. He admires you in every way. And most days, I feel like he is the reincarnated version of you.
Dad, thank you for having me as a son.
I'll try to do my best to be a good brother. Amen.
You know I had to be here. You here, baby. You here. Love. There we go.
Yeah. There you go,
Trey. Man, that's what I'm talking about. It was real.
My name is Aria, and my dad, I love him because I know who he is, and he's the best dad I know because I just like to play with him in my heart because he's still my heart, and I'll keep thinking of him forever and ever and ever.
On three, I want everybody to say, long live Dolph. One, two, three, long live Dolph.
Like, when I die, all this jewelry, these cars, this money is going to be passed around and swapped through hands and everybody, all my folks, and whatever they do with it. But when I die, like, when my kids ask who is their daddy, like, I'm still going to be their daddy. Like, it's the only thing that I can literally say is mine when I leave. You know what I mean? So, yeah, I take that dead serious.
Ooh, Swank, you a fool for this one.